Hi, I'm Caleb, and in this video, I'm going to share about who should be buying a resale HDB and the pros and cons of it. Today's video is a continuation of my options after HDB MOP series. If you want to watch back the previous episode, I've included a playlist over here. Personally, we help clients like you make the best decisions when it comes to your property needs. Do like and subscribe and click the notification bell to this channel so that you get more property and financial tips to help you make the best decisions when it comes to buying your next property. Alright, let's get into the video's content. So who should consider moving to a resale HDB after their MOP? I've identified three groups of people who should consider moving to a resale HDB. The first group is for people who want a bigger space yet do not want to pay much more in condo. The second group is for people who want a good value for money when it comes to a shelter over their head. The third group is for people who want to stay near their parents to get the proximity housing grant or to their near to their kids' school as well. So with regards to the finances and timeline, I have a complete guide walking through all the finances and steps you need to know when it comes to buying your HDB. Do check out the video here. So do like and subscribe to this video if you have found this video helpful, as it will help to reach more people as well. Buying a resale HDB will also have its pros and cons, and I will share more on the positive aspect first before going ahead with the not so good pointers. For resale HDB, the good part is that you are able to get a bigger size unit, especially the older flats. Secondly, it will also be much more cheaper in price compared to a condo as well. Thirdly, you'll be able to go for viewings, thus you're able to choose, see and feel the unit that you want, so that you will avoid buying into a unit that doesn't meet your criteria at all. The fourth reason is that you are able to buy a well-renovated unit, saving you money when it comes to renovation costs. And the last of all is maintenance costs. Maintenance costs is a lot cheaper compared to condo, and if you need rectification done, you can just simply call the town council and they'll settle it real fast for you. Right now, I'll share the not so good pointers when it comes to buying a resale HDB. When you buy a resale HDB, you will not be able to take up a term loan from the equity of your property, even if you have fully paid up for it. Therefore, if you need a sum of money for your kids' education, the only choice you can do so is to sell your house, so which might not be what some people would want as well. Secondly, decreasing value due to lease decay is another issue that older HDB will need to face, as only 4% of the HDB flats have been identified for the SERS program, Selective En Bloc Redevelopment Scheme. What this means is that once 99 years is up, your HDB will depreciate to $0 and HDB will surrender the land back to the state, and it will be recycled to build newer HDBs for future Singaporeans. Another not so good point is that your 5 years MOP will be imposed again. As such, you will not be able to make any property investment in Singapore within the next 5 years. Do like and subscribe to this video, as it will help in the YouTube algorithm as well. So I hope this video has been helpful for you to learn what's your next option after you have reached your 5 years MOP. Though everything has its own pros and cons, choosing what's best for you is always dependent on your needs and wants too. Watch out for my next video in this series, where I will explore the possibility of you buying a second BTO and the things for you to watch out for. Comment below what's something you have learned from watching this video, and if you will choose to buy a resale HDB. And if you need help getting the right property for you and your family, you can reach out to me for a short discussion. I'm Caleb. See you in my next video. Goodbye.